What do I love about Star Wars?
Seems like you could put yourself into the position of Luke Skywalker pretty easily.
The story is really what captivates me.
You know, after it was ended, everyone just kind of looking at each other, kind of going, "What? That was so amazing."
It was just so colorful and different.
It was the most amazing adventure I could possibly think to go on.
For those of us, like myself, who appreciate the idea of having something Star Wars related in their presence at all times, Sideshow delivers.
We have 1/6 scale figures that are superposable.
Some of our figures have light-up features. They have costumes that are just so intricately tailored.
You have quarter scale premium format figures. You have 1/5 scale statues.
We've got half scale, which is half the size of a human.
If you're somebody who's a little bit more higher end, you can get a life-size version.
We're not just taking 2 or 3 photos. You know, we're not just screen capping or Googling. We're putting in the time.
Every step of the way, somebody is doing countless amounts of research.
We review footage over and over and over. We try to go the extra mile, bring to life everything we can.
We wouldn't be where we are today without having that excitement about Star Wars.
All the artists here, they grew up with Star Wars and they love it so much. That eye for detail and nuance, it's poured into the product that we make, and I think it shows.
Everyone has their favorite moment, has their favorite character. We know some of these things like the back of our hand.
It's not just something that we love, but we know it's something that the fans and the collectors really love. And that passion that we have for it transfers over to them when they purchase it. And I think that's what makes it kind of special.
The love of Star Wars is so ingrained in all of our artists that we want to expand the universe in whatever way we can imagine.
What do I love about Star Wars?
Seems like you could put yourself into the position of Luke Skywalker pretty easily.
The story.
Am I live?
Yes, you are.
Woo! Happy May the 4th, everyone! May the 4th be with you. It is Star Wars Day here at Sideshow, and we're having a ton of fun. So we have people decked out in Star Wars gear, in casual costumes. We even have like a Captain Phasma with like full helmet wandering around. So I'm sure that you'll see a lot of these on our social feed a little bit
and
later.
And we've got Ray, too.
Yeah. What's up, guys? I'm Ray, and I am here to welcome you to Sideshow's May the 4th celebration. So how's it going? Are you guys having fun yet? We have so many fun things. We just watched our Star Wars collection video, and that's the first time it's been seen on the internet. We'll have it up on our social pages later today, and it is, of course, on our YouTube channel, but you guys got a look at how detailed and how intricate and how much love and care we put into everything that we do, especially Star Wars, because we love Star Wars. So some of the products that you saw in that video were, we had our Vader PF, our life-size Boba Fett, our 6-scale R2, which we'll be unboxing later so you guys will get a better look at it, and our legendary scale Obi-Wan Kenobi. I'm gonna BB-8 you guys and give you the little thumbs up. Speaking of legendary scale,
well, we've also got, by the way, a computer hooked up today, so that way
if you guys have questions for me
or comments
or just like awesome Star Wars quotes and shout outs, you please just, you know, comment, because I can actually hear.
I can hear as well.
I can hear as well, but I can see your comments. Like, apparently, you guys think that this is a trap somehow? Why would we want to trap you? And I am not dressed as Admiral Akbar. If I was, like, in full Mon Calamari gear, then you might have to worry about a trap. But no traps right now. Just always. You're right. This is definitely not an Apple laptop that is sitting in front of us right now. May the 4th be with you, Jonathan Hargrove, and thank you for tuning in. So let's get to some of the fun stuff that we have. If you go to sideshow.com/Kenobi, we have an Obi-Wan legendary scale figure up for giveaway. This thing is 3 feet tall, and it comes with 2 lightsabers. One of them lights up and one of them does not. It plugs into the wall so you can leave the lightsaber activated. It's priced at nearly $2,000, and it's currently on waitlist because only 200 are ever made. But you can enter for a chance to win one here on May the 4th. That is sideshow.com/Kenobi for your chance to win an Obi-Wan legendary scale figure. This thing's gorgeous. I don't know if you guys were with us at Star Wars Celebration, if you tuned into any of our Star Wars Celebration videos from 2015, but he was at our booth live. I actually got to dress him, which is a pretty fun thing to be able to like put a Jedi robe on such like a tall, intricate figure. But
I did the assembly video for right. as well.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah, it's cool to it shows up and it is wearing clothes.
Right.
But they're not like the full folded
yeah,
robes.
Yeah, you have to fold over the robes and you have to make sure that like the sleeves are correct so that way he can display the lightsaber the way he's meant to. So it's a really, really amazing figure, and whoever wins it, can I come over? Because I kind of want to like see it in person. I mean, there's one in the conference room, but like I want to see yours in person. Cool. So you guys know, I don't know how many times that we're going to say this during the live stream, but you guys know that it's May the 4th. And as such, we have a May the 4th page, celebration event page on our page. So that is sideshow.com/May4th16. So May 4th. So May 4th 16.
We've got a little URL popping up as well.
See, so that's why I love you guys. See, this is why, my tech team is here. And I have Dominic and Brandon, and they run everything while I get to answer all your questions. They answer mine. So that's why Sideshow is such an amazing family, and I love being a part of it. And so I really appreciate the support of Dominic and Brandon right now and our entire company for letting us do these fun May the 4th promotions with you guys. So on the May the 4th page, since I know that you're there right now, right? You're all there right now. And there's pre-orders. There are deals. There are promo codes. It's all for Star Wars stuff. And we're all huge Star Wars fans, right? We had... You know what my favorite thing today so far has been?
What's that?
So this morning, I put up, like, tell me your favorite inspirational Star Wars quote. Do you know who answered?
Who?
Mark Hamill.
Oh, nice.
What up? I was, like, super excited about this. He, like, liked it, and I kind of, like, watched the tweet, like, after he liked it. And he put up a Yoda one. I can pull it up, like, which one it was, but I don't remember off the top of my head. I just got so excited that Mark Hamill was on there. Anyway... if you go to sideshow.com/May4th promo, you can get $25 off on select Star Wars items, and that includes our Imperial Probe Droid 6-scale figure. Again, the R2-D2 6-scale figure. His buddy, I guess you can call him his buddy, the R5-D4. R5-D4 does not have a bad motivator, so you won't have to worry about that. You won't have to go get parts at the Tosche station or anything awkward. No whining Skywalkers. Just an R5-D4 looking awesome in his 6-scale glory.
Do you think they were friends?
Probably. They didn't know each other for very long. I mean, R2 was picked up, and R5 was probably kind of mad. Because how long was he on that Jawa barge? He had to have been on it, like, he couldn't have had the easiest time, you know? Being picked up. Like, R2 was really lucky.
Maybe a friendly rivalry.
Friendly rivalry. They were like mean droids. Someone write that fan fiction. Mean droids with R2 as Katie and R5 as Regina. And there you go. Wow. We also have our Jango Fett. And the bronze statues. So it's the Jango Fett 6-scale and also Jango bronze and Boba bronze. So the Fett family you can own as bronze glory in your household with our promo code. That's sideshow.com/May4th promo. Yeah? Okay. Whew. There's
right,
so much stuff.
Right
yeah, there's I'm going to look stuff. At what everybody's saying. more Star Wars quotes, obviously. I am a personal fan of I am a Jedi like my father before me. So whoever posted that one, my dad was a big Star Wars fan and he got me into Star Wars. So I am a Jedi like my father before me.
What was the first one he showed you? Was it New Hope?
The first one he showed me was actually Return of the Jedi, to be honest. Because when I was like a little kid, he thought the easiest way to get me to like Star Wars was the Ewoks. Because like Planet of Teddy Bears, duh. We have a couple of Ewoks running around and both of them didn't really want to be on camera. One of them's actually working the phones right now, so she could not be on camera. The other one just said no when I asked her if she would be on camera with me. Let's get me to answer what? There's a comment that says, let's get her to answer. I am looking at the messages. Same person wrote that. But yeah, it said, let's get her to answer. So whatever question that was, Marco Antonio Rojas, I would like to know what question you want me to answer.
There's a little bit of a lag also.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a lag. So I am looking at the messages and I do see that you have a question for us. So what would that be? Oh, Morris got, his wife got kids to do cutout masks of Ewoks. So if you send us a picture of that, that would be great, because I will totally post that on our Instagram of little kids in cutout Ewok masks. On Wednesdays, we wear restraining bolts. That's amazing. Hi, Amy. May the 4th. Yeah, you saw it. What did I? Okay, so whatever question Marco asked, apparently I already answered it. What's your favorite figure? That's a question on here from John. What's my favorite figure?
Yeah, I'm sure they're asking you.
Are you kidding me? What do you guys think my favorite figure is? I'm going to unbox him for you guys today. But what's Dominic, what's your favorite figure?
Speeder bike.
The speeder bike. Oh.
Speeder bike is my favorite.
That's a great figure. There's a How to Be a Poser that features the speeder bike and the scout trooper.
There's an instructional too, and that was quite complicated to put together.
Yeah, please be careful with your speeder bikes because they are complicated to put together.
I've always been a fan of model kits, and I feel like our speeder bike is like kind of close to that because of how intricate it is and how much it takes to put together.
Oh, Marco wants to know who would you be in the Star Wars universe, a rebel, a Jedi, or a Sith? I guess member of the Empire, like a trooper, would be there too. I would be a rebel. I have, like, that's not a question. I'm really, really excited for Rogue One because I feel like Jyn Erso is gonna be like my girl. Like, this is a rebellion, I rebel. Like, that's it, right there. What would you be?
I'm always partial to the bounty hunters.
Oh, so that's
colorful.
A good one.
I know that's not really one of the
options, but that's great.
If I were to live in the Star Wars universe, I would absolutely want to strap on like a jetpack and have a bunch
Mandalorian armor, man.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm really curious, Brandon, who would you be?
Tough question.
Brandon's soft-spoken, so I'm going to repeat what he says.
I would probably go with Sid.
Brandon says he'd be a Sith, so whoever says there's no Sith here, we have a Sith here. And by the way, you guys, there is a Sith in the building today, and the Sith took hold of a prize pack. And I was kind of a little bit upset at first, because, like, how do you compete with the power of the dark side, right? But then I remembered I'm dressed as Rey. So I'm a scavenger, and I scavenged the prize pack back. So here it is. It is a staff and battle droid 6-scale figure. A couple of random pieces from the smuggler's bounty. These are from two separate boxes. This one, I think, is from the cantina box. Maybe it's not. But this one was definitely from the resistance box, the C-3PO mug. And then we have my little droid friend on Jakku. A Sphero BB-8. So I scavenged this together because I'm a scavenger. And if you go to our Facebook page and scroll down a little bit, you will see that you have to offer yourself to the Sith Lord to win this prize pack. So why would a Sith Lord want to give you these prizes? And you just comment on it, and we're going to choose a winner at 3 p.m. Darth Nick is going to choose the winner. So be sure to make your offering. That was his given Sith name. Yeah. Like, he bowed down before his master, and he said, "Now you are Darth Nick," which is kind of standard for Sith, as far as I understand it. So that's, there you go. This is our random scavenged prize pack from it kind of is a lot of what this is the original trilogy, episode 7. He has a red handle. So this is obviously, you can tell, you might not have recognized this as 3PO because he has a red handle. And then this guy is obviously from the prequels. So we kind of have a nice array of Star Wars things that we scavenged around the office. How many times can I say scavenged?
You're really selling us.
Yeah, because I'm right today. Anyway.
Blocking your face.
It is blocking my face? Okay.
There we
go. I'm actually going to put these away because I need room to unbox R2 in a little bit. Cool. So yeah, just scroll down on the Facebook page since you're already there watching this live stream and enter for a chance to win our bag of Star Wars that is, you know, owned by a Sith. Cool.
What else have we got going on for May the 4th?
Jeez, so much.
I know.
If you guys are on Instagram, you're going to want to play Collect a Day May. We have a rad May the 4th Star Wars giveaway. He feels the pull to the light, but, you know, he's strong with the dark side, and that is a little hint as to what the giveaway today is for Collect a Day May. Whew. Okay, so now we have pre-orders on our page. You can pre-order the McQuarrie Vader statue, and it's based on a concept by Ralph McQuarrie's representation of Darth Vader, which I think the helmet in particular looks stunning. Just such an amazing piece. If you're a fan of Ralph McQuarrie's artwork, you're definitely going to want a 3D rendition of this. That's at sideshow.com/buyVader. The statue is just under 2 feet tall, not quite all the way 2 feet. He's made of polystone, and he has a blue lightsaber and an alternate helmet concept.
That's so, the McQuarrie concept for the helmet.
Oh, okay. Okay, cool. I was like, I have notes on my computer also, because it actually takes a lot to memorize a whole lot about, because we have so much stuff that I can't memorize everything about everything, but I do have Dominic, Brandon, and my trusty, not...
Unbranded
computer. red box computer. That's what it is. It's a red box. Anyway. We also have a Kylo Ren premium format figure that went up for pre-order. That's sideshow.com/buyKylo. He has a tailored costume that the fabric on this is... Apparently it has to be printed 8 times. It has to go through 8 rounds of printing in order to get the texture and the pattern and everything movie accurate and perfect. If you get up close to this Kylo Ren figure, you can see how much detail we put into it. It's just, I've never seen costuming fabrication on a statue quite like this. It's fantastic. So he has his outstretched hand because he's stopping force blasts midair, which, by the way, when that happened, like beginning of Force Awakens, I was like, are you kidding me?
Yeah, that was a good moment.
And it was a great moment also for Poe, because Poe's like being marched past and he's just like, are you kidding me? Like, this thing is like in midair. So that was a great way to establish Kylo Ren as just this crazy badass Sith Lord who's like, I will show you the dark side. And he really did.
Does that force power have a name?
Like freezing someone in the force?
Well, it's not someone, it's like that.
But he also does it to Rey later, because he like, boom, and then, yeah, it's like a freeze thing.
I've heard it referred to as force stasis.
Force stasis. I'm actually kind of, I'm watching comments because I bet someone knows what it's called. So if you could help us out, do you know what freezing something in the force is called? Is that canon? Like, is force stasis canon, or is that based on... It's not.
It's based on Knights of the Old Republic, so...
Oh, I love Knights of the Old Republic.
But that's what Such the power was game. Called, and it did the same thing. So I don't know if it was... I don't know if it's the same power, or if there's a new name for it.
So if anyone knows, comment.
Because KOTOR is now...
Force Freeze! Oh, that's Force not... That can't be it. Mic is too low? What does that mean? Like, you can't hear me? Are you guys having problems hearing me? My voice changes a lot in pitch. That could be Facebook. Because we had problems with the Nick Fury unboxing. And Facebook Live, the sound compresses strangely.
Luckily, this time...
Force hold.
Yeah, that's pretty
good. That sounds good. Force hold. Okay, I will try to talk at like a regular, consistent volume for you people. Apparently, I sound like Muppet Susan, which I enjoy Muppets. So, like, I'm cool with that if you are. I don't know. It's called a force hold. Doesn't matter. Okay, fine. Someone says doesn't matter. It's cool. Yes, doesn't matter. It's cool. Fair enough. Let's move on.
More pre-orders,
because we still have two more pre-orders, and that's the legendary C-3PO and the legendary R2-D2, which, by the way, is at sideshow.com/buy droids. If you buy them together, you can save $250. So if you're a fan of both the droids in the original trilogy, actually, they're in all of the movies. They're in all seven of them, and they're in the Clone Wars cartoon. They're basically like our constant for the Star Wars movies and the Star Wars universe. You kind of go on their journey because they're the first thing you see. Anyway, I love R2. So obviously, I adore the fact that we are making legendary scale R2 and 3PO. Legendary scale is half scale, by the way, to like break it down for people watching. So that means these droids are huge. Like,
we have a companion shot.
Yeah, okay, cool. So there's a companion shot that you guys are going to be seeing now. But again, if you buy the bundle together, you get $250 off, and they're at sideshow.com/buy droids. So R2 comes with a light-up head, an articulated dome, and a magnetic restraining bolt for... wear a restraining bolt Wednesdays or whatever that. Now I forgot it. It was so clever and I already forgot it. Cool. And C-3PO has light up eyes, an articulated head, and he also has a magnetic restraining bolt. So that way, you know, I mean, once you get these half scale droids, you kind of don't want them wandering around. Like, I know R2 is a super devoted droid and he needs to get this message to Obi-Wan. But I wouldn't take the restraining bolt off of him because we also know he can be kind of a loose cannon, that R2. Speaking of R2, can I unbox them now? Am I allowed?
Whatever you want.
Okay, I think I'm going to unbox R2 now. Do you guys want to see me unbox R2? I'm going to wait until someone says they want me to unbox R2. C-3PO, I'm sorry, does not come with a red arm in legendary scale figure form. His red arm is restricted to, you know, the base of the Resistance. And also, these were meant to match from the original trilogy, and they're not from The Force Awakens. So, since Ryan has said yes, he would like us to unbox R2, we are going to unbox R2. And... now everybody's saying, yes, yes, do it, do it, do it. So I'm excited.
Do you want to come around the other side to do it?
Is it going to, like, do a weird... No, I can do it from here, I think.
As long as you show the camera stuff.
I can do it from here. Okay, so when you open up R2, the thing that I love the most about this R2-D2 figure is the fact that it tells a story. If you look at it, like... it has so many different moments of R2-D2's story through the original Star Wars trilogy that any R2 fan, like, needs to have it. There's just no option for you in this case. So what we're going to do is, so it comes with, if you're one of those collectors that leaves everything in the box, you actually can, there's a window panel so you can see R2 and everything he comes with in the box. You can just take up an awful lot of space on a table. Displaying him like this. Okay. So, R2. There's a little tab. You can be careful about doing that. Open it up. And with R2, this is how I like to unbox him. Because he slides. See, just slide him out. Okay, someone has said that the volume works better now, and I saw Brandon adjusting it, so you guys can all thank Brandon for that. So yes, R2 just slides right out of his outer box. And then you just take him out of the other side, like this. He's plastic on both sides, so you guys aren't gonna like pull him out and then have everything explode if you're careful. If you just pull him out without caution, then you might explode all of his accessories. Okay. Top panel, pull it off. And there's also another extra protective layer of plastic, which I was super grateful for when I unboxed my R2 at home, because these, doodads, his little accessories and attachments, they can fly out really easily. So be careful. They're not gonna break. They're very safe. But let's get R2 out. He lifts out. Beep, beep, wow! Hi, friend. So R2, he's articulated, and his third leg comes out. So I'm gonna just stand him up right here in front of the camera while I get out the magnetic lightsaber here. When unboxing a 6-scale figure with tiny accessories, tweezers are very helpful. So I recommend collectors get a set of tweezers to pull out particularly difficult accessories from their plastic boxes. So what's so cool about Luke's lightsaber, so this is the Return of the Jedi Luke's lightsaber, is it serves as a magnetic panel to unlock all of R2's, bolts and stuff. So you can open up all those little panels. And that was the battery not working on this. I need to take it. Oh, okay. Well, I'll show you guys how to do that.
Otherwise, it drains the battery.
This isn't Sideshow. These aren't Sideshow branded tweezers, but they are like Sideshow black and silver. So we kind of faked it, right? But thanks, Bill, for the tip. He thinks that we can brand tweezers and sell Sideshow like collector tweezers. So there you go.
Might happen.
These are super helpful to get these little glasses of green out, which attach to R2's Return of the Jedi tray. So it's really easy. There's like a peg at the bottom. There's a hole here. It's a simple attachment system. But let's show you how to turn on R2 really quick, because I know that this was something that collectors had questions about. Because R2's head does move, but it also comes off. So you have to hold the bottom part, like where his two stripes are at the bottom of his dome, hold them in place, twist, and he'll lift right off. So a lot of people were confused about that. And I don't blame you, because if I didn't know, I would be very confused as well. I'm sorry, I need to make him light up, so I have to take his head off. So there's a tab on your brand new R2. Pull out the tab to activate the battery, and then there's also a switch to turn him on. So you're going to want to pull the tab and flip the switch, because if you just pull out the tab, he's still on off, so he still won't work. And then you can see while I have the dome out, we can get he's touch activated. So you just touch him on one of his panels and he lights up, and he has like 360 view of R2. Lighting everything up. This is such a detailed piece. And as a lifelong R2 fan, I can't even believe I'm so lucky that this piece is made in my lifetime.
Were you a fan of R2 from day one?
Yeah. From day one. Gracie, who's in charge of our print program, wants me to make a spreadsheet of everything I own R2 because she hates when she sees something R2 and she's like, oh, Susan must really love this. Oh, Susan probably already has it. So you get R2's head back on the same way. You hold the two bottom bars in place so they don't keep spinning. Put the head back down, and then you're gonna want to give the head another little twist so that way he can go back to his articulation and motion. So yeah. Yes, that's actually a very good tip from Alex. When you leave him even off on your shelf, it can still drain the battery. So you're gonna want to, if you know you're gonna display R2 for a very long time, you're gonna want to take off the dome and flip him in the off position. So yes, you could also use him as a nightlight if you wanted to. But yeah, you can't leave him on. The battery will drain. And then you're gonna want to remove the dome and flip the switch to off in order to preserve the battery. So if you know that that's something you're gonna do with R2, display him for a long period of time, you will want to remove the dome and flip him to the off position. Personally, my R2 gets a lot of love in my house. My cat hates him. I don't know why. I think it's because he thinks of R2 as like some sort of affection competition, but you know, webs. Okay, so here is, let's start with A New Hope, shall we? This is, there's a little plastic thingy over this. So there is a plastic sticker over a magnetic port, so be sure to take that off. And there's a little magnetic port to take this out, so that way you can display your Princess Leia hologram. So again, peg into port. And again, pull out plastic tab. This one does not have an on-off switch because it has a little, it's the tall one, guys. Oops, it's the tall one. There we go. So there's two little hooks. The tall one is the switch. And then you can display him like this. And he can be like, help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope. You fought with my father in the Clone Wars. And now I ask for your help again. There's Death Star plans in this R2 unit.
Which obviously is exactly what she says in the movie. I was quoting it verbatim, in case you didn't know. Or I'm lying. Okay, so like I said before, what's great about this is that it tells the full story of R2 through the original trilogy. So this is our New Hope. On Empire, you have all these fun little, again, yay tweezers, man. You have all these fun gadgets that can pop out. Oh, look at that panel. So this is when he's trying to steal back Luke's dinner from Yoda. No, it's not. It's the torch. Yeah? Yoda has the torch and he's like, and then R2 puts out the little claw to try to steal it back, and then Yoda's like, mine, mine, mine. Right? I'm right about that. So.
Could you take out all the accessories and just drop the box?
Oh, good call. There's lots of little plugins for R2. Oh! He also comes with a magnetic restraining bolt. There you go. Don't go anywhere, R2. We're putting you together. So, losing the box. Oh my gosh, these little glasses without tweezers, I don't know how to get them out. There we go. And losing the box. Woohoo! So, R2 on Dagobah. He has his little grabby guy. He has this little zappy guy. And this is obviously how he plugs into computers to get them off of Cloud City. And then he reads that the hyperdrive on the Millennium Falcon has been tampered with. And then C-3PO yells at him. And then he's like, I'm right. And then he fixes it and saves the day, like he always does. Hey, R2, the unsung hero of the trilogy. How much can I, like, plug about how much I love R2?
Quite a bit.
I know. Yesterday I was buying Star Wars Bloodline because that came out for May the 4th, that the new Star Wars book that's about General Organa before The Force Awakens. I'm super excited to read it, but the cashier is like, hey, there's an R2 on your arm. And I was like, yeah, and I'm buying Bloodline, so. Anyway, Star Wars is my first fandom, so I always have a special place in my heart for it. All of these accessories go together. They do, I swear. With this, like, this.
It happens to the best of us.
Yeah, but also, I should have put this together before I put all the little glasses on.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so they. Little glasses come off. They snap together. I swear. There we go. They click. So you hear a click, and then you know they're in place. And this just attaches to the top of R2. So. Yeah? Do we hear a click? Probably not. Anyway. Well, I just rolled. Oh, there it is. Okay. So all of these complete R2's Return of the Jedi storyline when he is a slave to Jabba or a secret agent. I like to think of it as a secret agent because clearly he knew what was going on the whole time. Oh my gosh, stay open.
Deep undercover.
Deep undercover, secret agent. He knew what was going on the entire time because, as you know, he was the one harboring Luke's lightsaber. So yeah. So that just attaches to R2 right here. And there you have R2's complete storyline. Yay, R2! This is more of a love letter to R2 than it is an unboxing video. Well, you got two for the price of one. So, like, how grateful are you, Sean? There is not a spring to shoot out the lightsaber. Sorry. Does it spring out? Because you can keep the lightsaber in him.
You can keep the lightsaber inside.
But I don't think it springs out. I've never tried that. And I'm not going to try it live.
Where do you put lightsaber?
I believe you put him in here. Well, actually, on mine, I put him in this compartment because it's the easiest one to put it in. The compartment where you put the lightsaber in is now covered by his... removing. I didn't like when you were a slave. Or secret agent. I felt like they weren't very nice to R2, and I'm sorry. Oh, that's also Dagobah. Where is it? That's another one. I believe this one also opens. Oops. I can't figure out where this, because I know that it goes in the top. Go down. But I actually keep mine in here. I wonder why this panel's being weird on this one. Anyway, that's where I keep mine. But that panel's not opening. Cool.
Let's talk about some of the cool things we've got on May the 4th in case anyone's just tuning in.
If anyone is just tuning in now, you're gonna want to get to our May the 4th page. Sideshow.com/May4th16. So that's May4th16. And that is where all of the pre-orders that went up today. So the pre-orders include C-3PO Legendary Scale, R2-D2 Legendary Scale figure, Ralph McQuarrie Darth Vader Premium Format figure.
Nope, statue.
Kylo Ren Premium Format figure, Darth Vader statue.
That's right.
Darth Vader is almost 2 feet tall, so that's really cool. And he has the Rob McQuarrie concept art swap out helmet. So he's very slick looking. There are promo codes on that page that get you $25 off on select Star Wars items. So we're talking like the Imperial Probe Droid, which also, by the way, speaking of giveaways, there's an Imperial Probe Droid giveaway on our YouTube channel right now. So if you are into the Hoth sequence, which opens, doesn't open Empire Strikes Back. They open Empire Strikes Back on a Star Destroyer, yeah? Anyway, but there's the Imperial Probe Droid being dropped. He doesn't have a self-destruct, which is good because you're gonna wanna keep that Probe Droid around for like secret missions. But we have an Imperial Probe Droid 6-scale figure.
It does make noise, though.
It does make noise. It has a voice box, but it does not have self-destruct, which is good. You don't want that happening in your house. It's a mess. Gears everywhere. It's just really embarrassing.
And we've also got the...
Oh, thank you. Apparently, someone thinks I'm very good at droid noises.
We also got the How to Be a Poser for Boba Fett.
Boba Fett, How to Be a Poser. So if you are like Dominic and aspire to be a Mandalorian bounty hunter, you're going to want to check out how to pose your own 6-scale Mandalorian bounty hunter. Yep. Talk about the R2 premium format, please. We have one, and it's fantastic. What else do you want me to tell you about it? Yeah.
You pull up the page and...
I can pull up the page on my red box, unspecified. No, Google. Not Google. Go back. A lot of people must be on our website right now, which I love, because the website just, like, is being a little slow.
May also be our internet for doing the live stream, actually. Could be our kind of hogging the bandwidth a little bit.
All right, here's the R2 premium format. Wow, he's cute. It's a standard premium format figure. He comes on a. Oh my gosh, why am I blanking on this? The base is from Cloud City. I don't know why. I was just like, what on earth? Oh no, it's the Millennium Falcon base.
It is
the Millennium Falcon base. Yes, it's the Millennium Falcon base. And he, again, pairs with his C-3PO. I've been talking straight for like an hour, guys, so I'm starting to get tongue-tied. His C-3PO premium format figure companion, because they go well together. They're like BFF, you know? We're writing more fan fiction where we can do a buddy comedy with R2 and 3PO. Good cop, bad cop. R2 and 3PO. Cool.
Any final questions? I think we're getting ready to wrap it up.
Yeah.
Remember that URL for the May 4th page?
Sideshow.com/May4th16. So May 4th, 16. Like, as in today's date. Yeah. Yeah, it is a good day. We're having so much fun, guys. So tune in to all of our social channels. We have Facebook. We have Twitter. We have Instagram. We have Pinterest. We're doing fun May the 4th Star Wars things across all channels. And how do you sign up for a contest? Which contests? Because on the Obi-Wan contest, you sign up on our website. You can just go to the May 4th page. There's a link right there that takes you straight to the Obi-Wan page.
There's also a link specifically for
There is
Obi-Wan.
A link specifically for Obi-Wan. And let me find that in my notes. It is sideshow.com/Kenobi. So sideshow.com/Kenobi sends you straight to the Obi-Wan giveaway to win a chance at an Obi-Wan legendary scale figure. This thing's 3 feet tall, guys. 3 feet tall. It's spectacular.
The light-up feature is awesome on it, too, because
yeah.
I like the plug-in, because you can have it in your living room.
Right.
Just have his lightsaber on.
Someone wanted a nightlight.
Yeah.
Obi-Wan legendary scale figure nightlight. A 3 foot tall lightsaber nightlight. That costs $2,000.
Not if you win the giveaway.
Not if you win the giveaway. But like I said, it's waitlisted now because only 200 pieces were ever made. It was super limited. Super limited because it's such a, it's so beautiful. And the portrait, the Alec Guinness portrait, it's like having 3 foot tall Alec Guinness in your living room. That's what it's like. So there's that. You can win on our Facebook page right now. You can enter for a chance to win our scavenger prize pack that I scavenged throughout the office of various Star Wars goodies that include a STAP battle droid 6-scale figure, a BB-8 from Sphero, and 2 exclusives from the Funko Smuggler's Bounty box. But they're from 2 different boxes. So if you don't subscribe to the box, or you subscribed and you missed a box, these are from different boxes. It has been requested that we go out with our Star Wars video.
All right.
Again? Yeah? So thank you guys all for tuning in, and come play with us on May the 4th, sideshow.com/May4TH16. And you guys, May the 4th be with you. Always.